All right, welcome back, folks. We are here with one of my favorite segments on this show. It's always the food segment that I really get antsy about. I'm just kidding. We are here with Dina Duvicas. Welcome to the show. She is the owner of Burger Mania, located here in San Bernardino on East Street. Mm-hmm. Pretty good stuff. I have a personal story that I will tell later, but no, we'll get to that later.
Oh, no, I love it. I was going to say it's like so good. You guys were voted best burger. Mm-hmm. And that's best new restaurant.
That's right. Last year by The Sun, we were voted best new burger and best new restaurant in the Inland Empire.
That's kind of exciting.
Very exciting. It was definitely an honor.
You know, I know Daniel had a personal story, which probably segues into kind of like the atmosphere of what Burger Mania is.
Absolutely.
Personal story or maybe four. I've eaten here plenty of times, and I have to say, every time I go, I try something different. It's always the burger that catches my attention. Bacon avocado, I get really creative with it. Mm-hmm. I'm like, everything you got back there, just throw it on there. Mm-hmm. But I've also tried your turkey melts, which are delicious. I haven't tried a chicken salad, but it looks good. But then another thing that I was noticing on the menu that I don't wake up early enough for is you folks also have breakfast.
That's right.
And that is fantastic.
A lot of people, they don't realize the name doesn't show everything we have on the menu, Burger Mania. You don't really know that we actually have breakfast, and we have over 100 items on the menu, and a lot of those items are served from 6 to 12. We have everything from monster breakfast burritos to Mexican breakfast plates to you have a sweet tooth, we have some French toast, we have pancakes. So we have the works, and we're open at 6 a.m.
6 a.m. Mm-hmm. Burger Mania, guys, set your alarms.
That's why I said I didn't wake up early enough for the breakfast. I'm just, you know.
So you want like the atmosphere that you wanted Burger Mania to be. How would you describe it?
It's a lot of people will look at Burger Mania and they think it has a drive-thru, so we're fast food. Mm-hmm. I never ever label Burger Mania as fast food. It's always quick service to me because you will have the speed of fast food, so you can get in and out of there in less than 7 minutes sometimes if you gotta go and you gotta go to work.
Right.
But when you're sitting there or you're in the drive-thru, you're gonna have a dining feel. You're gonna have somebody walking up to you making sure that your meal is tasting just the way you ordered it. Mm-hmm. You're gonna have somebody wanting to pack up your food when you're ready to go. So you have almost a full service feel, but the speediness of fast food. And I think it's really important to our guests, and it kind of sets us apart from regular chain fast food type places that really you're just a number.
Yeah, it really does, because I've never had somebody from a fast food chain ask how my meal is going.
Right, sure, yeah. And I think that's what makes us really unique.
Right.
I mean, I know all my customers by name, they bring in their children, mm-hmm. I know their grandparents, you know, I get the full life family story. Mm-hmm. So it really does set us apart.
Now, how long has Burger Mania been around?
The original location in Rialto, which is located on Foothill Boulevard, has been open for about 11 years. And the one right here on East Street, it has been open 5 years in March.
And doing strong, which is very exciting.
Yeah, you know, we are very, very excited. It was a huge venture for us. My husband and I opened it together, and we've been sticking through day in, day out, and we're there now 5 years.
You seem very awake for how busy you probably are at this place.
It's part of my restaurant training that I know how to do this 24/7.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's talk more about what's on the menu. So 6 a.m. you have a full service breakfast, which is super exciting, and something I know is there's always something cooking in the kitchen. You have something new and exciting.
Well, we love in the kitchen, we absolutely love to kind of play around, and even our guests, we have people who come in who have food allergies or have special requests. I'm the first one to cater to it. Mm-hmm. I love creating something new. Even this week, we had something that we called the Chicken Club.
Yeah.
It's just like a club sandwich, but we threw in grilled chicken breast. Mm-hmm. And everything in-house, by the way, is made by us. Nothing is pre-made or anything like that. So there's a lot of prep involved and a lot of love involved.
That separates you from the competition as well.
Yeah, you know, it's fast food, but it's really not.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what we have, 100 items.
And that's exactly why I like about it. And that's why you were voted best restaurant also. Because when you do go in, you don't feel rushed. You don't feel like, you know, let's get this food quick so we can get them out of here, get the next person in. Mm-hmm. It really is, hey, what would you like? Take your time. Mm-hmm. I mean, you can make it, like you said, in 7 minutes. But I'm pretty sure most people go in for the family feel.
Oh, absolutely.
And the attention to service. Mm-hmm. That's not around a lot these days, especially with...
It's very uncommon.
Yeah,
it's very uncommon. Even in dining establishments, you'll notice that, you know, the economy hit, things were happening, and there was kind of almost a depressing feel around.
Yeah.
I don't want that. I want people coming in, and I want them happy, and I want them relaxed, and knowing that no matter what they want, we'll take care of it for them.
Yeah.
It's awesome. And you have a good personality also to be working in a restaurant.
Thank you. And that's why we do it. I absolutely love the restaurant, and I love my husband's back of the house. So if you ever see a guy running around in the back, that's probably my husband. We're friend of the house, so I take care of the customers and the communicating and all that stuff.
Now, what does the future look like for Burger Mania? You're being so successful now. Or are you wanting to open anything again in the future?
We would definitely like to expand. We're thinking maybe somewhere else in the Inland Empire. So we would stay in the Inland Empire because I think it's really important that the Inland Empire has a little bit of a little pick-me-up. Kind of, you know, I want to really focus on the Inland Empire because I feel like it's lost its sparkle and it's kind of lost its people are traveling out of the Inland Empire. I want them to stay here. I want them to know that there's places to go here with your family or, you know, on your lunch break or whatever the case may be. So if we do expand, we will expand within the Inland Empire.
And another great thing is that your entire menu is online at Burger Mania World.
That's right.
BurgerManiaWorld.com. And so people who have never been there can actually take a look at your menu before they go and give them a basic idea of the different types of things on the menu.
Absolutely. We actually have quite a few of the large companies within the area. They'll look online and place very large phone orders and pick up 20, 30, 40 meals at a time.
Oh, so cool.
So you can definitely find us at BurgerManiaWorld.com. And
do you have a phone number?
I do, yes. It's 909-885-7226.
And you are located on East Street.
That's right.
Right? I know there's some construction going on right now.
There is some construction. We are located at 930 South East Street. Due to the construction, they have kind of a cut off the center lane, but you can make U-turns at either light on North and South Mall, so you can easily access us.
It's worth a U-turn, folks. Trust me. I know what I'm talking about. I'm a professional. Well, thank you so much, Dina, for being on the show. We really appreciate you coming on. Folks, now you know where a great spot is for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Don't forget Burger Mania here in San Bernardino. Thank you again, folks.
Thank you.
And we'll be right back.